going on, fam? It's the entertainer, the motivator, the educator, Lecky Murray. And I'm doing an exclusive interview at CHH Now. This young lady right here has been, you know, supporting the site. Has been definitely in the communication. Love her music. Just love everything she's doing. She got a new single, Strong Tower, that is out now. And so we had to chop it up. I have my girl, Kate London, in the building. Kate, how you doing today?
Hey, I'm awesome. Thanks for having me.
Yeah. And, you know, the funny thing is, I always want to start off with this. Your testimony story, because I think a lot of times we don't necessarily talk about where or how we came to faith. But talk a little bit about how you came to faith in knowing the Lord Jesus Christ.
Oh, totally. Yeah, it's been a journey. Like, I was in the world for a long time, I think as many of us were. And like, I really started I had something inside of me that said, you need to start going to church, you need to start going to church. And this is probably in like 2011, but I still was like walking my own way. I was just, you know, partying, doing all the things that we do. And, you know, I started, I actually relocated where I didn't know anyone. And I was like, okay, I'm here in this new place. I don't know anyone. And my manager was like, you should check out this church, because he was a believer. And I got plugged into this church here where I live in the Palm Springs area. And like, the Lord just like totally met me there. And that's where my faith just started growing. And I started singing on their worship team, got involved, made like all the friends I made was at that church. And that's how I really started like walking with the Lord. And from there, it was just its own journey, you know. Like, there was a lot of stuff, like past stuff that had to be worked out, like with many of us. And it's been a journey. Like, I wasn't like delivered, I'm cool, I'm okay. Like, I had stuff.
Wow. And you know, the funny thing was, you said that you had a manager before you even knew Christ, that he was a believer. So God was putting in seeds. So what type of music did you do before you came to know the Lord Jesus Christ?
So it's kind of funny, like the story of, for me with music actually didn't happen right away. There was always something inside of me that loved music for sure. I loved singing, I liked writing, but I was afraid. And I told myself for a long time, or maybe the enemy told me, you can't do that. You are not a good singer. You have no connections. You can't. And so in my mind for the longest time, I wanted to, but I was afraid and I was insecure. And so I did nothing with it. And my confidence started building when I was on the worship team at this church. And it just was like bubbling inside of me, like, you have to do music. And so then I kind of started doing research and making some connections. And I had a friend that kind of helped me get started. But the funny thing is, I didn't even do Christian music right away. I did secular pop. And it's funny because like, the Lord had to work that in my heart. Like, I don't want you doing this type of music. So I had songs that were about guys and, you know, sex. And like, I've honestly taken them down. I removed a lot of them because that's not who I am. And I didn't write those songs. So I was getting started and I was kind of just taking direction and working with other people that wasn't even like, it wasn't even me, which was interesting. Like, I was just making music, make music. But now I'm in a place where I only want to make music that glorifies the Lord and that speaks my truth about what I'm going through, whether it be, you know, hurt or struggles. So he had to like work. He let me do it though. He said, okay, go ahead. Walk your path. And you know, but then I felt the Holy Spirit was just like, I don't want you doing that anymore. And so it's been a journey. It really has. So it's been cool. He's met me every step of the way.
You know, the funny thing is, I speak to a lot of artists, and the main thing they think that is a switch that turns on when you come to faith, that your music is supposed to automatically and spontaneously change. You had to walk that route, and you did the secular pop scene. And then as the Holy Spirit just convicted you, you slowly stopped doing the music. And now your music, because we talked about this off the air, but your music is a combination of pop, hip hop, a little bit of R&B. It has so many different elements in there. Could you talk about your sound and how did you come up with the Kate London sound?
Yeah. So I've always liked a lot of different types of music. And I've always really liked hip hop music. Like, I like Travis Scott, you know, The Weeknd, all these different rappers. Obviously, like, I'm not going to make music quite like that. But I kind of, like, where I'm at with it now is I've just searched for beats online and, like, something that connects with me. I'm just like, I think I want to write to this. And I just have this, like, portfolio of beats that, I don't know, I just like, and a lot of times they are hip-hop beats. Like, the categories doesn't say pop, it says hip-hop. But I'm like, I don't care, I'm going to make it into a pop record. And so I just kind of evolved that way. But yeah, I just, whatever, like, I hear, I like, I'll hear it and be like, yeah, I want to use that one. So I don't know. And yeah, I just kind of like to blend. Like, I'm definitely not a rapper, so I have done a little bit of rap though in the past.
No, it's funny because when I hear the actual record, I'm like, this is a hip hop record. But I was like, mm-hmm, but the way you craft your songwriting and the way you compose it, it's like, wow, the way that you took the record, I would have never expected somebody to take that record that way unless you have foresight in how the record is going to be. So let's talk about Strong Tower, your new single that you just released. Talk a little bit about how did you come up with the whole concept of Strong Tower and, you know, the recording. Give us all the details as far as how did you come up with this song, Strong Tower?
Yeah, for sure. So last year, I started getting really inspired to write songs that out of the word. So I'd be like reading the Bible and I would just get like words or phrases or a scripture that really would stand out to me. And I would jot down some words. So I was originally in Psalm 91 and I did like a worship song out of that. But I felt like there was also a song I could pull from there that was more of like a pop upbeat kind of fun track. And so I had jotted down like some of the lyrics for Strong Tower, and then I kind of went out and I looked for like beats, if you will, that I thought would be a good fit. And with this one, I can't take full credit. I did work with a writer. So I kind of gave her like the base of like lyrics and the beat, and she kind of helped me with the melodies and stuff. And then she'd send it back to me. She had different words. I changed the words. So, yeah, just it kind of went back and forth as a flow. But yeah, I feel like this song really is, you know, the Lord is our strong tower and he's always there for us, you know, and that it also goes with Proverbs 18:10. It's like it specifically says the Lord is a strong tower. Those who run to it are safe, you know. So I don't know. I just felt like it was a cool record and it sounded like I wanted it to sound like commercial, you know. I think that there's a lot of Christian music that it is just worship music, and it kind of like I kind of want it to be like maybe a non-believer would listen to this,
yeah,
you know, and like the record. So yeah.
It, you know, it's a great record, you know. I listen to it, it's very catchy. The thing is, my question is, since we're in this new time of COVID-19 and a lot of stuff is not open, are we going to get a video for this single? Are we going to get a supporting tour?
I don't know. I was thinking about that. I did a lyric video. So I did that, just to have something to kind of, you know, put out with it, but I don't know that I'm actually going to do a video for this song. I have a lot of other music I'm working on. I have like a portfolio going and, you know, I fund all this myself. I don't have anybody helping me. So, you know, music videos, studio time, all that stuff is cost money. And so I'm kind of like prioritizing where I'm going to, you know, spend and whatnot. So I don't think I'm going to do a video for this. I might do a video for my next song.
Gotcha. Because it seems like with your music and the stories that you tell, it's like you want a visual behind it, whether it's not, it's like a professional video, some type of visual where we can kind of see, okay, it makes sense. So with the Strong Tower of record, as far as your manager is concerned, what does your manager help you with as far as getting your career started, and what are your goals as far as where do you see yourself in the next, you know, 2 to 3 years?
Yeah, totally. So at this time, I actually don't have a manager. I'm on my own. But, you know, I'm really like right now, and this is something I've had, like, if you're familiar with like prophecy and stuff, I've had so many prophecies through my church, really not about being an artist, but about being a songwriter. And I feel like I've always been a writer since I was a little kid. Like, I'm real emotional and I would just be writing out poems and all this stuff. So I've been doing a ton of songwriting. And so I feel like I'm kind of stepping into that right now, which is why I'm just like being creative. And I don't know, I'm going to start like kind of seeing if I can go into that lane a little bit and focus on songwriting and see where, you know, the Lord leads me with that. But sometimes, like, I can write the lyrics all day, but sometimes it's the melody that needs work. So I just want to keep training and going into that. But I'd really like to start kind of not only promoting myself as an artist, but also collaborating as a songwriter. So I'm kind of like doing research now and seeing, you know, what it takes to be in that lane as well. So I'm probably going to be putting up, if you're familiar with Sound Better, they're a great resource. I've used them for a lot of things. So I'm probably going to be putting up like a portfolio there with some of the songs I've written and stuff. So as an artist, hey, I can sing for you and I can also write. So I'll be doing that. Yeah, and within the next 2 years, just that, like just keep going. I don't have like, you know, I want to get signed to a record label because that's just such a big, you know, I don't even know if I would want that at this point, you know, so I want to be able to continue to be creative and, you know, trust the Lord with what he has for me. And if he wants to open doors, okay. So I don't know, I'm just going to trust him and keep doing what I'm doing.
Absolutely. And you know, you said the main thing that I think that's the theme of your interview and the theme of your career is the fact that you're doing something that, you know, your brain or yourself told you you can't do or you didn't feel comfortable, but you're pushing past the fear. And I think the main thing, if artists listen to this and watching this, is that the fact that you have to push past fear. Because, like I said, if you can sing, that's half the battle. I know for me, I got a lot of songs that I can write, but I have to have somebody that can sing them, and I have to have somebody that can sing the melody, because if you're pitching it, you have to have it completely done in order for somebody to take it in and kind of give you a shot. So that's great. We pray that you continue to do your music as well, because we don't want you just to leave your music behind just to be a full-fledged songwriter, you know. So that's awesome. So Kate, one last question I wanted to ask you. How did you come up with your stage name, Kate London?
Kate London. So I remember, gosh, in like 2015, I was thinking, like, I wanted to keep Kate, and I was thinking of different things, and I had a friend at the time who was, like, helping me. And we just wanted something that was pretty simple but catchy. And, you know, I love traveling. I've been to London a couple of times, and I just thought that sounded cool. Like, we were, like, shouting out, like, different cities or just places, like we kind of researched, like, how do you come up with a stage name? Like, and just kind of threw around ideas, and if I'm being honest, and Kate London sounded cool, and I just thought it, you know, it was easy. Like, if somebody wanted to look it up, it wasn't complicated. Like, it's real straightforward. So and I just think it flows well. It sounds commercial. So
it sounds like you have a lot of money, you know. I understand, as an independent artist, independent creator, it's like, it's a grind. And one thing I can appreciate you is the fact that, you know, you do put money behind yourself. And you are, you know, serious. And a lot of people don't understand that that's the name of the game. Nobody will not put any time or effort into you until they see that you put time and effort into yourself. Kate, where can people find Strong Tower, the single, find you at? Let the people know exactly where to find you at.
Absolutely. So Strong Tower is out on all platforms, iTunes, Spotify, what are the other ones? Amazon Music. It's out on all platforms. So YouTube. And then all my social media is at Kate London Music for Twitter, Instagram, Facebook. So you can check me out there. And I have other music out too. You know, you want to check that out as well.
And everything will be linked into the video and also to the blog post that's disconnected too. So we will be muchly covered with CHH Now as far as everything Kate London. But Kate, thank you so much for this interview. It's been a pleasure. I'm looking forward to hearing more things about you. And if you're an artist yourself and you're looking for a singer, a songwriter, a co-songwriter, you know, Kate would be the person to go to, because if you hear a lot of her songs, you know, Jesus Got Me, that's a previous song that she released, Strong Tower, and all the other songs, you notice one thing, and they're written very well. So again, Thank you, Kate, so much. It's the entertainer,
thank you.
The motivator, the educator, Lucky Murray, with the exclusive interview with Kate London. She has a new single, Strong Tower, released now. It's available through all platforms. Go streaming up, you know, or you can do the old-fashioned way and buy the download. That'll help us out a lot, you know. But thank you so much. But stay tuned to chhnow.com for everything, Kate London, and Lord willing, we'll see y'all next time.